I'm voting yes on two.
This communication was paid for by the campaign to regulate marijuana like alcohol. Top contributors are Marijuana Policy Project, Drug Policy Alliance, and Thomas...
It's time for the 420 Radio News, covering the latest headlines in consumer cannabis, medical marijuana, and industrial hemp. Transcripts of 420 Radio News are available daily on our website at 420radio.org. Now, here's Russ Belville with your marijuana headlines in 4 minutes and 20 seconds.
This is your 420 Radio News for Thursday, October 23rd, 2014. In a televised debate over Florida's Medical Marijuana Amendment 2, opponent Sheriff Bob Gualtieri said, quote, "This is about smokable marijuana for recreational use because people want to sit around Saturday night with the strobe lights going and Cheech and Chong playing and smoke their pot," end quote. Quote, "It's a medical issue and an issue of compassion," end quote, countered John Morgan, the attorney who is spearheading the push to pass Amendment 2, and often cites the experiences of his brother and father fighting cancer as inspiring his passion for the cause. Polls have shown support for medical marijuana in Florida so far falls short of the 60% needed for a constitutional amendment. Morgan said if it doesn't pass this time, he would, quote, probably, end quote, try again, suspecting that the measure would do better in a presidential election year. Dr. Ronald Schwartzler, who caused an uproar at a Tuesday night debate on marijuana legalization in Oregon when he claimed that 5 Colorado children died after consuming the drug, on Wednesday retracted his statement and acknowledged he was wrong. Quote, "I really need to retract that statement because I can't back it up," end quote, said Schwartzler, the medical director at Serenity Lane Addiction Treatment Center in Eugene. Schwartzler appeared on a panel debating the legalization initiative, Measure 91, at Portland State University that will be rebroadcast at 9 a.m. Sunday on K2, Channel 2. When the discussion turned to the issue of how legalization has worked in Colorado, Schwartzler said, quote, "Let's concentrate on those edibles. There have been 5 infant children deaths in Colorado that have picked up those drugs," end quote. Several people in the audience began rebutting Schwartzler, yelling, "Not true," and "What source?" After Schwartzler retracted his claim, Peter Zuckerman, a spokesman for the Yes on 91 campaign, called it, quote, "yet another example of how opponents of marijuana reform have for 70 years been using misinformation and scare tactics," end quote, to keep the drug illegal. Residents in the neatly groomed enclave of Laguna Woods, California, where the median age in 2010 was 77, say medical marijuana has become a necessity for many trying to manage pain. They smoke it, eat it, dab lotion mixed with cannabis on sore joints, and summon sleep with a pot-spiked candy bar. Although many of the believers in Laguna Woods Village have used marijuana off and on for much of their lives, 85-year-old Pat McClintock never considered it until her back pain set in. McClintock obtained a medical marijuana recommendation from a doctor in March and joined a collective. Now she exercises every morning, goes to the hot tub in the evening, and squirts drops of marijuana oil into her mouth every night. A Dickinson, Michigan man faces a possible prison sentence after his 6-year-old daughter showed up to school reeking of marijuana. Randall Raymond Fike Jr. on Thursday, October 23rd, pleaded guilty in U.S. District Court in Marquette to manufacturing 50 or more marijuana plants. The charge carries a maximum penalty of 20 years in prison. Fight came to the attention of authorities January 29th after his daughter showed up for kindergarten at Woodland Elementary School in Kingsford, quote, with a strong odor of marijuana on her clothing, end quote, Kingsford Public Safety Sergeant Joseph McGeaney said in a criminal complaint. The principal said the girl told her teacher that her father, quote, was growing marijuana plants in the basement of their residence and that she was not supposed to tell anyone, end quote, the sergeant wrote. Parents from across the country, including a group of moms from Florida, are traveling to the Bay Area of California to give their sick children what they can't get at home, medical marijuana. Quote, "We are here for safe, consistent access to medication for our children," end quote, said Renee Petro. "It's medication they can't get at home because what they want to give their kids is marijuana. These kids, either with forms of epilepsy or brain tumors, have tried all the pharmaceuticals doctors have recommended. Some have helped, but pot helps more than most. And in Florida, you can't legally buy it. They're living in a gray area of the law in Florida, which allows for CBD oil, but does not provide a place to get it. Coming to California to obtain a medical marijuana card when they aren't living in the state of California is likely illegal. They don't care. They'll do whatever it takes, and they've come to learn what they can about the drug, and California is the place to do that." This has been your 420 Radio News for Thursday, October 20th.